Hey everyone, welcome you all. In the today's video, I'm going to show you how we can handle AJAX calls through Selenium automation. So first of all, let us try to understand what is AJAX call means. So AJAX call is basically a technique that allows a website to update part of its content without reloading the entire page. So for example, let me show you. So here you can see, there is a button called load AJAX content, right? So normally what happens when you browse any web page, so currently I'm just browsing this page and this page will be loaded, right? It takes us some few seconds. Let me just browse this URL once again. Now you can see the page is loading here. The entire page is loading, and once the entire page is loaded, the DOM is available. Now, suppose if you just click on this element, load AJAX content. So this will also try to load some content from the server, but it is not trying to load the entire page. So for example, when I send this request, the entire page is loading. You can just notice here. But when you click on this button, just observe, the page is not loading, but still it is trying to get some content from the server, and that content is displayed here. Some content is got loaded from the server. So what does that mean? What is the meaning of AJAX call? AJAX is nothing but an asynchronous JavaScript and XML. This is the full form of AJAX, asynchronous JavaScript and XML. So what exactly we do in this? It is a collection of techniques that make web applications more responsive to user interaction. That means without loading the entire page, we just try to load a partial page or the portion of the page. So this particular part or portion is trying to get the content from the web page without reloading the entire web page. So that is basically called as a AJAX call. So an AJAX call is a web element, a web development technique that allows a website to update part of its content. This is more important. It try to update the part of its content without reloading the entire page. This is basically called as a AJAX call. Now, so what is the challenge which we have in automation when you handle this type of AJAX call? So this AJAX call happens many times. Sometimes it may happen once you click on the button. Sometimes when you're working with some dropdowns, right? Those dropdowns elements comes from the server. That is also kind of AJAX call. So many times these AJAX calls will be happening in the web pages. So what are the challenges normally we face with the AJAX content or when you're loading the AJAX call is, so no such element exceptions most of the times we will get. For example, let me click on this. So this is taking some time to capture the content from the site, right? This is taking some time. So before loading the content, we are trying to find this content before loading itself. So that is basically causing the no such element exception. So to handle this type of AJAX contents, normally we prefer explicit wait. So by using the wait statement, we can handle the AJAX content. So let me show you practically how we can achieve this. So let's go to our Eclipse, and this is my project already created, Maven project, which contains all Selenium WebDriver dependencies. Now, let me create a new class, handle AJAX calls. Simple, we need to just use an explicit wait statement to handle the AJAX calls. So for that, I'm just creating an WebDriver instance here and launching the page. So this is a page I'm launching, and just import this WebDriver. Right, so now I have launched this page, and now I want to just click on this element, load AJAX content. Now inspect that element, go to selector hub, capture the XPath for this. So this XPath is matching with that element. Now I'm taking this XPath, go back and try to click on it. I say driver dot find element by dot XPath. So this is basically an element. I want to perform the click action here, right? So let's go to click, and after clicking, what happens? It will try to load some AJAX content. I just clicked on it. Now, after a few seconds, it is trying to load some AJAX content. So this I want to verify. So just inspect that text after loading. This is basically part of this H2, right? So go back to the selector hub, and this H2 tag is content, the text actually, but instead of doing this based on the content, it is generated XPath. Instead of that, I'm taking some parent element, because sometimes if the content is got changed, we will not able to capture it. So inside this H2 tag is there. So I'm just say H2. So this is matching the element. So now I'm using this XPath to capture this element. So now I say driver.findElement by .XPath. And this is the element. From this, we need to extract the text. This is actually what loaded text. Okay, I call it as a loaded text or a loaded text, a loaded element. So we will extract the text later. Okay, just say loaded element. And what it is basically a web element. It is a web element. All right. So now from this web element, we need to extract the text. And after that, I'll try to display the text. Simply, I can say system.out.println load element dot get text. So this will able to capture the text from the loaded content. So simply what I am doing, I just click on the button here. And after a few seconds, we capture this text, this element. And from that element, we capture the text. Just simply, we have done three steps. Okay, let's try to execute and see whether we are able to capture the text or not. So whenever I click on the button, there is AJAX call is gone to the server. After a few seconds, we capture this text. So now if we go back and see, we got a no such element exception. So why? Because unable to locate an element. So this element is representing the loaded text. So which is not able to find here because the AJAX call has happened. It takes a few seconds of time. So it is got delayed. So now how we can handle this AJAX call? So to handle this, simply we can use explicit wait. So for that, what you need to do is, so we are expecting this element to be present or this element to be visible, right? So after clicking on the button, this element should be visible on the page. For that, we need to wait. So let us create explicit wait by using WebDriver wait. Say WebDriver. Using WebDriver wait class. So WebDriver wait, I call it as a my wait equal to new WebDriver wait, and we need to pass two arguments inside this. One is our, we need to pass driver instance, and the other one is time. So duration dot second, let me take 10 seconds max. Okay, so we need to import this WebDriver wait. So this is the declaration of explicit wait. Now we need to use this explicit wait to put certain condition on this element. So for that, what you need to do, I take my wait dot until. So here we need to put condition using expected conditions class. So expected conditions dot. So what is the method we can take? So I'm looking for the visibility element is located. So I'm taking this method. So visibility of element located. So I'm taking this method. Visibility of element located. So which element is located? Because we are saying located, we need to provide only locator part. So this part I will pass it here, right? So once this element is visible and located, this will return the web element. So that I'm going to store in a variable. So we don't need to write again find element explicitly. You can just capture this here. So explicit wait method, wait for that element visible. And after that, it will return the element. So this statement is not needed. So the explicit wait is waiting for what the element should be visible. Whatever element we are putting here, that should be visible. And once it is visible, it will locate that element and return the web element. After that, we can capture the text from that web element. So this is how we can handle the AJAX call. Now let me execute and see. This will solve the problem. So now launching the page. Maximize. Now click on the button. After a few seconds, we capture the content here. Now can go back and see. We got the content message. AJAX content is successfully loaded. So by using explicit wait, we can handle AJAX call. It can be text. It can be drop down. Sometimes it can be button. Sometimes it can be dynamic content. Whatever it is, it is an AJAX call. So AJAX call is nothing but what? Without reloading the entire web page, we are still updating some part of the web page by sending the request to the server, which is basically called as AJAX call. That we can handle by using explicit wait from Selenium. Okay, so that's all for this video. Thanks for watching.